Next, we're going to work on pole sits. Fair warning that this one hurts at first. I promise the pain goes away with enough practice. Go easy on yourself. Just try a couple per day. It's okay if you can't learn this right away. Work on it gradually. It'll get easier and easier. It's also important for this one that you're wearing short shorts. There is a reason that pole dancers don't wear much clothing. Your skin is what sticks to the pole. And if you're wearing leggings or tights particularly, you'll slide right down. If your shorts are too long, they'll get in the way. So try to pull out a nice short pair of shorts so that your thighs can really grip onto the pole. We're gonna do this from the floor. I recommend starting with your dominant hand on top at first, but always trying things on both sides. You're gonna wanna bracket your lower arm. This is something we haven't gone over yet. It's not too difficult, but it feels a little awkward at first. So your top arm grabs normally. Your bottom arm is gonna wrap around the pole so that your hand is on one side and your elbow is on the other side. And I like to think of it as being similar to the way you put your leg for your fireman stand, where your knee's on one side and your foot's on the other side, hand on one side, forearm wraps around so that your elbow's on the other side. And this forearm is gonna be across the pole on the inside side of the pole, close to your body, not around the outside, that doesn't work so well. And this top arm is just regular grip. So you're gonna press with this forearm. It'll give you a lot of leverage and prevent you from bashing yourself into the pole, which is not comfortable. You're gonna pull both your legs up in front of you with the pole in between them. Cross your legs. You wanna make sure that your knees are stacked on top of each other, directly on top of each other, ideally, so that you're crossing at your knees rather than your ankles. You cross at your ankles, and even with really strong thighs, you're gonna slide down. So you wanna make sure those knees are crossed so that you can't see both of them. And then you're gonna tilt your hips towards your lower leg. So whichever arm is on top, that leg should also go on top. Bracket this arm, pull your legs up. My right arm is on top right now, and so my right leg is also gonna be on top. Once you're up here, you can unbracket this arm. I'm crossing so that my knees are stacked on top of each other, and I'm leaning toward my left leg because it's on the bottom. Practice holding this here for as long as you can. I know it hurts. Hang in there. It does get easier, I promise. And come down. Practice this on both sides. Make sure you point your toes. And once you can hold your pole sit, once that feels strong, not necessarily comfortable yet, but once it's strong, you can get up into your pole sit. Bring that top arm, once you're up there, once your hips are tilted, down to face level, and let go with the lower arm, and lean back. You will start to spin a little bit even on a static pole. That's just a lean back from your pole sit. You're gonna wanna make sure that you're nice and extended. You wanna make sure this arm is low enough, so face level is a good starting point, so you can really get a good extension on that. If you wanna go even lower, grab a little bit lower, but we don't wanna be inverted yet. We don't wanna grab too low.